We're gonna skate to one song only.
I'm gonna get you drunk off my lady hump, my hump, my hump, my lovely lady hump.
We interrupt this program to give you a bulletin just received from one of our naval units at sea. A large object traveling at supersonic speed is headed over the North Atlantic toward the east coast of the United States.
An unidentified object was picked up 200 miles southwest of Point Barrow, Alaska.
Shall we report it, sir?
What, that we're being invaded by little green men from outer space?
Flying saucers have invaded our planet.
It was a saucer. A flying saucer.
Brought to evidence, these creatures have scientific knowledge far in advance of our own.
We've come to this planet looking for intelligent life. Oops, we made a mistake.
Welcome again to the podcast that showcases humans behaving badly. This is why the aliens don't come. My name is Brendan Millett, and with me is the colorful Michelle Poitras.
Except that all my colors are black because I'm night pain.
And I'm back pain.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. My back. It hurts so much. Actually, my god. No, my back is fine.
My Did emo, I... my little emo heart. It hurts so much.
Great. This turned into an emo podcast. Just what I need. Well, better than last week when, you know, the ending kind of turned, it kind of fell flat because of...
Fem rage.
Yeah. We don't need any fem rage. There is no fem rage this week.
Thank God.
That I'm aware of. I went through the script beforehand. You know, I have my little notes and everything. And
Yeah.
Yeah, no fem rage.
Thank you.
There's something else you're not that keen on, but no fem rage.
Oh, no.
But let's not get ahead of ourselves, shall we? Don't cry. It'll all be over soon.
Oh, God. Relax and let it happen, Sugar Cube.
Anyway, if you're new to the podcast, please find us on SoundCloud, YouTube, join our Facebook group, and follow us on Twitter at...
TIWTADC.
Yeah, I kind of stepped over you at the end of the podcast last
no,
week and actually
it's
did
fine.
That.
I started
letting you do it because I could never remember the order of the initials, but I've heard you do it so many times, I know it now.
Well, and that's fine. As long as it gets mentioned.
It'll get mentioned.
I don't care who says it.
Yes. How many tweeps do we have, anyway?
Not that many. Like I said, I haven't really been good about keeping up with it,
oh,
so...
Shit.
I have to be better about it. I'm sorry.
Way better. He's gotten better.
I'm going to go start a fight.
Yay, Wayne's World.
Yay. That was Wayne's World 2.
Was that Wayne's World 2?
Yes.
I don't know. It's been ages
yeah,
since
because
I've seen
that was
those
Chris
movies
Farley.
Over 20 years old.
Yeah, because that was Chris Farley
God,
in that
Wayne's
role.
World is over 20 years old.
Yeah.
Shoot me.
Yeah, first one was 1992.
Where does the time go? I was 30 yesterday. I'm going to be 40 tomorrow. Not literally, but...
I know.
Yeah. That's a whole other thing.
Yeah.
You know, to tell you the truth, I'm thinking about having, like, a big to-do for the big birthday this year.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking if I do, we might want to do a podcast from my birthday party.
That would be interesting.
Yeah. So.
I might have to get drunk for that.
Ooh. I haven't seen that in a while. I might have to get drunk for that. I'm going to be drunker than you. You're not going to be 40.
It's true. No, but I'll be 38.
Shut it. Anyway, folks, thank you for joining us again. If you're new, welcome. We've got some great stuff for you this week, but of course, we're going to start out as the same way we do. I can't talk again this week. As we do each and every week with something called headlines.
I said the headlines. Headlines. Have you heard it? Headlines. Headlines. Hit it.
Got some cute ones this week. Not too many that are, like, over-the-top, horrible, like, oh my god, like last week.
Yeah.
Those were really fucked up last week, particularly the last two and the common theme there.
Yeah.
Yeah, but these aren't quite as bad, but they're cute, for
okay.
sure. This first one is local high school, let me try again. Local high school dropouts cut in half. That's a pretty stiff penalty. Stay in school, kids,
because yeah, really?
You don't want to get cut in half.
No.
Yeah.
Well, now that begs the question, was it just, like, Jason Voorhees style? Was, like, hitting the pendulum? Like, how did they go about this?
Pendulum. Yes, they set up the pendulum in the gym and just...
Yeah, there you
know,
go.
Whatever happened to just climbing the rope, you know?
Yeah, that's... Oh. I don't know. I think I'd rather be cut in half than climb a rope.
At this age, fuck yes.
It'll be faster.
It'll be faster and a lot more effective because I'm not getting up
There's
that rope.
There's no way I'm getting up that rope.
Nope. Not when I got sciatica putting on my fucking socks. That ain't going to happen. Yeah, climbing the rope will make me feel funny. All right. Yeah. Oh, second Wayne's World reference already.
Jeez. Oh, boy. It makes me feel
But yeah, local. Funny. Obviously, they mean the dropout rate was cut in half.
It's a local high school dropout rate.
Yeah, throwing rate. This isn't Twitter. There isn't a character limit.
Not a character limit.
Yeah. I might have done this one before. It sounded familiar, but I'm not sure. If this is a repeat, I apologize.
All right.
Hospitals are sued by 7-foot doctors.
No.
Never did that one?
No.
Obviously, this is how... Which,
7 podiatrists.
Right. It's what you, it's the word you enunciate. You know, 7-foot doctors or 7-foot doctors.
Mm.
But I've never seen a 7-foot doctor.
No. Or I've never seen 7 doctors that were only a foot high either.
I didn't even think of that.
I'm here for you, babe.
This is Dr. Tom Thumb.
Oh, Dr. Tattoo.
Deplane. Wow, we just made 2 very dated references.
Yeah.
Yeah, only our old listeners will get those.
Yeah.
The rest of you kids, ask your folks.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah.
Go ask your parents.
Go ask your parents.
Oh, boy. This one, come on, people. There's no way you didn't catch this. You did this on purpose. Kids make nutritious snacks.
Yes, they do. I mean,
can it be babies?
I mean, nothing.
Wow. Oh, boy. Now, obviously, they mean kids are making nutritious snacks.
For themselves to eat.
To eat.
Yes.
Not that kids make nutritious snacks. Did you catch the Buffy reference that
yes,
I did at the time?
Yes, of course I did.
Okay, you didn't react to it.
No, but you totally stepped over my joke to make your own. Like you always do.
Oh, boy. Trouble in paradise.
If this is paradise, I want a refund. Refund.
See, you saw early TIWTADC. This is middle TIWTADC. Where the tension starts and then we break up and then we get back together 20 years later. And
we're saying, like, Michelle quit the podcast and now we're back together.
Last week, Michelle quit the podcast.
Now we're back together.
Misunderstanding. Didn't give a fuck.
Doesn't matter.
And we're back together again. La 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 la. I can't believe we just did that shit.
Oh, I can. Come on.
Long live the D.
Long live the D.
Oh, my God.
Seriously, Jack Black, call me. Call me.
God, you and chubby musicians. Oh, right. We're not supposed to call the other one chubby because he gets all self-conscious.
He is beautiful, you know, no matter what.
Because he listens, you know.
Yeah, because of course he's going to hear
listens, you know, because, you know, you guys are buds and everything.
We're best buds, totally.
Oh, yeah, total besties.
Yeah. He loves me.
Right.
Apparently there's a name for that disorder, and actually none other than my Twitter bestie, the one who's far more obsessed with Fall Out Boy than I am. She actually posted that the definition of, like, imagining that someone of a much higher station in society than you is in love with you. It's like there's a name for that delusion. Mm-hmm. It's some kind of mania.
Mm-hmm.
And she posted, she's like, oh, well, this is awkward.
Well, he is hugging you rather enthusiastically in your Facebook page.
Not as enthusiastically as he hugs her, but she's gorgeous, so. Well,
she is cute. I'll give her that.
Mm.
She's very cute.
Yes. Call me.
I'm kidding. Anyway, I'm kidding. Next up this week is lung cancer in women mushrooms. I didn't know there were male and female mushrooms.
I thought they were kind of like agendered, like
gender
fluid. I don't know, non-binary.
I love that term. Oh, my God.
I do, too. I love the term gender fluid. Mm. Like, I think it's great.
Oh, I wasn't ragging on it. I'm just not 100% sure what it means.
It basically means you don't really identify with either one. You kind of a little of both,
an episode of Star Trek. There was this race of people, Next Generation, so you don't care.
It's fine.
But, no, they get to this planet where everybody is just kind of like, as you said, like kind of androgynous,
you know,
just like not one gender, and it was actually a crime in their culture to lean towards one gender or the other.
Oh.
Riker ends up falling in love with one of them.
Okay.
Yeah, it was like the closest Star Trek ever came to tackling homosexuality or anything or other than just or gender issues or anything.
Yeah, yeah.
It was the closest thing. But anyway, no, obviously they mean the rate of lung cancer in women is mushrooming.
Yeah.
Not that women mushrooms are getting lung cancer. One, they have no gender, and two, yeah, no lungs.
Yeah.
There's a fungus among us. Don't you sigh at me. I'm a fungi. If only I was doing the dad joke segment again, that would have been a perfect segue.
Yeah. I often feel like a mushroom. I'm kept in the dark and fed bullshit.
Nice. This one's just cute, I think. Milk drinkers are turning to powder.
Oh!
Poof! Just like that.
Is it Lott Lott's wife turned to salt?
Are we talking Lott as in the Bible?
Yeah, the pillar of salt.
I think.
Like, don't look back and turn into a pillar of salt, something like that?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Wow, I don't think we've ever tackled the Bible on this show before.
Yeah.
Mainly because I figure if we did, we'd burst into flame.
We're still here.
But obviously, they're meaning milk drinkers are turning to powdered milk.
Which is...
But people aren't drinking milk and turning into powder. I've never had powdered milk.
Oh.
I think I used it as a cooking ingredient.
Yeah,
once.
Yeah, I can
That's
see
different.
It for baking, but just drinking powder?
Yeah.
The idea of that just... Oh.
Yeah, it's kind of nasty.
Yeah, the only time I use milk is in my coffee.
Yeah, I use it in cereal.
Mm.
I can't drink just like straight up milk because if not, you're not going to want to be around me for a good hour because...
I can, I just, I don't.
Horribly, horribly flatulent.
Yeah, yeah. The lactose intolerance ones in my family. I didn't get it, thank goodness, but...
Yeah, I mean, like, I can eat cheese and everything like that, but it's just like if I drink just regular milk, the only time it didn't happen was when I got farm fresh milk. That did not bother me at all.
Yeah.
But regular milk just from the grocery store, oh, we're talking some eye-watering, wallpaper-peeling flatulence.
You mean worse than usual?
Way worse.
Wow.
Yeah.
Because on a good day, you're pretty awful.
I know, but this could these farts could be weaponized. Wow. Okay, seriously. Yeah, weapon of ass destruction. Yeah,
jeez
totally.
Louise.
And finally for headlines this week... Deaf mute gets new hearing in killing. Discuss.
I must kill to obtain my new powers!
Take a drink. She broke the Brendan. Oh my god.
That's totally like the like you eat someone's heart and like you obtain all their essence and their fucking powers and shit.
So this deaf guy is absorbing people's hearing?
Yes! It's like an episode of Charmed.
Well, there was that that vampire in Anne Rice's books, Maharet, who had lost her eyes before she was made a vampire.
Yes.
And she used to take eyes from her victims and pop them in her head so she could see.
And they would work for like a while and then
they would
die.
But obviously hearing in this case is a court proceeding.
Yes,
and this
well,
deaf mute killed somebody.
Yeah, yeah. No,
presumably
I get
not
it.
To. Yeah, but presumably not to absorb their hearing.
Hey, you know,
like he's some kind of hearing vampire.
Maybe he takes their ears and is like.
I don't think it works that way.
It's not how this works.
It's not how any of this
works.
Oh boy!
But come on, that's pretty good. Just.
Yeah, just pop them on. Yeah. Make sure they match. They're not too big, you know. I'm all ears. Anyway, so as promised, there's no misogyny or fem rage this week. However, there is something coming up that may not make you very happy. And yet, those are the sounds you make when it happens, too.
Oh, shut up!
There's good news and bad news. There's only two stories this week for what I'm about to do, but one of them's kind of long. One of the reasons the aliens don't come is that juvenile pricks like me seem to find bodily functions rather amusing.
I fucking hate you. Drink.
I may drive Michelle to drink again just because of this little bit I like to call accidental poop.
Make poop. Everybody in the club wanna make poop. Everybody in their car wanna make poop. Everybody going on a date, make poop. Everybody running late, just make poop.
I'll be gentle. As gentle as I can possibly be.
Just get it over with.
Sounds like a conversation we had a long time ago. Inappropriate.
3.5 years later.
Mm-hmm. Wow. You're like going to want to date me just so you can break up with me again after this segment, I think.
Probably.
Anyway, so this person says, I was at a roller skating rink and had skates on. Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Like you do.
Well, not everyone that goes to the roller rink puts on skates and gets out there. Maybe they go in because they often have other things like video games and laser tag.
True.
And shit. So.
You know, the last time I was at a roller skating rink was with you.
I believe it.
In the 90s.
Yeah.
And remember, I figured out how to go forward. I couldn't turn.
Yeah.
I literally had to hold on to you to turn.
I know. And I was actually getting frustrated. I'm like, you're fucking holding me back, Millet. I'm a really good skater, actually.
Like, I want to, like, you know, friggin' roller disco my brains out. And you're just like,
I'm going to fall.
I don't skate. I tried it with ice skates and I could barely stand. It's just not a thing I can do.
You got weak fucking ankles.
Yeah, because it was fucked up because we're such big hockey fans and I cannot ice skate.
Oh, I can.
I can't do it.
I can.
Yeah. Well. Excuse the shit out of me, my new personal hero. Anyway, what, you're making poop noises during the poop segment. Oh, if you could see her face right now. So this woman's at, I think it's a woman. I'm not sure. Anyway, roller skating rink, skates on. I already hated pooping in public, which I do too. But I had
we
to go so
that.
Bad. But I had to go so bad I could taste it. So there I, that's just gross. So there I was with my skates on in a bathroom with no doors on the stalls. In hell.
Yeah.
When some creepy, skeevy bastard came in and started staring at me and playing, quote, paddle ball with himself. Yeah.
No.
Yes. I tried to get up and get away and fell on a men's room floor in a roller skating rink while a perv watched with poo hanging out. So there you go, internet. My worst moment ever. And I just shared it with everyone. Too bad I couldn't enter that one in the worst school moment contest. That would have won, right? And ever since, I refused to shit in public. Ever.
Wow.
So, had to poop in public, in a bathroom with no door stalls, and a perv diddling himself. And then falls over in front of this person with half a turd hanging out. Who Thanks. Did this person piss off in a previous life?
Me.
Well, no, they pissed you off in this life, because I just read it.
Yeah.
But that's just, what?
Yeah, that's like, that's hell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's, ooh. That, just the perv would have been enough without the poop.
Yeah.
But that's just insult to injury.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I'm kind of creeped out by that story.
Okay, can we move on?
If we must. Okay. I only have one more story for this bit, but it's a little bit of a long one.
Okay.
All right. I went out to dinner with my girlfriend at the time to this Italian place, and we both ate our fill and then some. As I was driving her home, let's just say I felt a great disturbance in the force. But I figured I can wait till I get home. She and I had not been dating long, so I would have felt weird dropping a mud monkey at her house. You hate the segment, but you like the terms, I think.
No, I actually...
You didn't like the term mud monkey? I thought you were laughing. I could only see out of the corner of my eye. Where was I? Mud monkey. Right. So I brought her home and began the half-hour drive back to my place. At this point, we are on full brown alert. I'm so overcome with the almost survival instinct level of need to poop, I doubted I would make it home. Then I had a stroke of brilliance. I worked in an office park about 5 minutes from where I was. I had a key card so I could get into the building 24/7. I could use that bathroom. So, clenching my ass cheeks so tightly they would go on to be sore for 2 days. Wow, that's hard. That is some hard clenching. I pulled into the office parking lot, scanned my card, and made my way toward the restroom. Thank God no one saw me because I was both running and clenching at the same time, so I probably looked like I was having some kind of seizure. I get to the men's room, dash for the stall, turn, and as I reach for my belt, that was the moment my colon had reached capacity. I had been a mere five to 10 seconds earlier, my underwear would still be alive today. I like the way they put this. Mount Vesuvius erupted, and as I continued to drop my pants and sit on the toilet, brown magma gushed forth into not just my underwear, but down my leg, onto the floor, and on the toilet seat itself. So I'm shitting while sitting and standing in shit at the same time. Jesus. Once I was quite certain the storm had passed, I exhausted the stall's supply of toilet paper, cleaning up the aftermath. However, there were still small smears on the leg of my shorts and sock that refused to come out. I wrapped the underwear in a paper towel, threw them in the trash, and went home. When I walked in the door, my roommate was there and started talking to me. Keep in mind, I'm standing there with shit stains on me and praying to God, Allah, Buddha, and the Great Pumpkin he won't notice. Apparently, there is no Great Pumpkin because he asked about them. I told him it was chocolate from dessert, excused myself, went and took a shower. To this day, he doesn't know it was shit. You're just staring at me. You got nothing? Not a thing?
Nope.
Nothing?
No.
No assist? No comment?
Nope.
Really?
Really.
You're that horrified?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Sorry.
You suck.
I hate this segment.
All right, you know what? I'll just fucking retire the segment. Since you refuse to melt.
Like, I'm actually, like, nauseous.
Really?
Yeah.
It's not like you're seeing it.
In my head, I kind of am.
Yeah. All right, no more poop.
Thank you.
Perp. I might bring it back on my birthday.
That'll be different.
As a little gift to myself.
Then I definitely have to.
But, I mean, if you're not even going to attempt an assist here, it'd be pointless for me to do this segment anymore.
I'm sorry. It's too gross.
Well, shut. All right, fine. No more poop. Bring down the whole room. At least I didn't choose to close this week's show with that segment.
Thank you.
So we have somewhere else to go to cleanse the palate and the underwear. Sometimes.
That okay. All right, you got me with that one.
Sometimes as human beings, we just blurt stuff out without thinking about what we're saying and are unintentionally either hilarious, offensive, or some combination thereof.
Like a 20-minute story about poop.
We call this, Did I Just Say That?
You didn't say that. Tell me you did not just say that.
Okay, three of these actually have a theme this week. But before I get to those, I have one that is not in accordance with the theme.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what the context of this was, but somebody wrote this to somebody about something, but they forgot a few words.
Okay.
This person says, in accordance with your instructions, I have given birth to twins in the enclosed envelope. Wait a minute. Uh-oh, I broke her. How big is this envelope, first of all? Why did you give birth to twins in the enclosed envelope? And where are you sending them?
To Abu Dhabi.
Really? A Garfield reference?
Yes.
When he mails Odie to Abu Dhabi?
Nirmal.
I thought it was Odie.
No, I would never send Nirmal to Abu Dhabi.
Oh, right.
I'm near Nirmal, the cutest kitty cat in the whole wide world.
Mm-hmm. Actually, you do that voice better. You're doing the Nirmal voice. That's happening. Hold on. Fucking Nirmal.
I am Nirmal, the cutest kitty cat in the whole wide world.
Oh, that pierced my eardrum. Like a dog's head exploded down the street. Oh, but yes, I have given birth to twins in the enclosed envelope. Like they're proofs of purchase.
Yeah.
Oh. The next few of these, though, have a theme. They're tenant complaints.
Well, no, wait a minute. I got to back you up for a second.
Okay, sure.
Did she give birth to the twins inside the envelope? Was the whole thing happening in there?
I don't know. I wasn't there. I wasn't holding the envelope.
But did you just put the twins in the envelope?
Well, she squeezed them out.
And put the twins in the envelope and then just send them away.
Yeah. What was she sending away for?
Because now, like I said, now I'm picturing her inside like an envelope.
They're going to like smush them together and make one good one?
Like her sitting inside like a Kool-Aid packet or something, giving birth to...
Oh, yeah. You know, I have this compulsion. Anytime anybody mentions Kool-Aid, I have to say, have
oh, yeah.
I have to do it.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
No.
But anyway.
Anyway, sorry. Go ahead.
No, the next three are tenant complaints that were not worded well.
Okay.
At all. All
right.
So this person says, the toilet is blocked and we cannot bathe the children until it is cleared.
In an envelope.
In Abu Dhabi. Think about what that they just said.
The toilet's blocked.
And they can't bathe the children until it's cleared. Well, you bathe them in the tub, presumably.
Or the sink, presumably. Or,
yeah, not in the toilet.
Yeah, what?
Don't take a butt bath.
No. God, no. Like, how's your hand, foot, and mouth?
Yeah, no. If you're bathing your children in the toilet, they should be taken away from you.
No, I mean, it could stand to reason that a clogged toilet could affect the rest of the plumbing.
Fine, but the way it's worded implies...
Please rethink this.
Butt bath, yeah.
Please reconsider your decision to bathe the children in the toilet.
Yes.
Please.
Even if it's in the tank, don't.
Yeah, no, don't. No, just no, don't. No,
granted,
no, no,
in the
no,
tank
no.
is clean water, but still.
Don't care.
Don't
no.
care.
No, no, no,
I'm
no.
not justifying a toilet bath, okay?
Yeah, no. Say no to butt bath.
No butt food, no butt bath.
No butt anything.
Or to
anything.
Hear you tell it, no, yeah, I was just going to say, no butt anything.
No butt anything.
De butt, nothing but de butt. The next tenant complaint.
Okay.
And did I just say that? Will you please send someone to mend our broken path? Yesterday, my wife tripped on it and is now pregnant.
Say it again.
Yesterday, my wife tripped on it and is now...
No, say the whole thing.
Oh, the whole thing. Will you please send someone to mend our broken path? Yesterday, my wife tripped on it and is now pregnant. I didn't think you could get knocked up that way. She fell down and poof, a baby.
Is that like Evil Dead pregnant? Like, because is it like a wooded path and like...
Wow. Did you just reference the scene in the original Evil Dead? I think the tree.
Yeah, the tree, yeah.
Which, wow. I can't believe you went there. I'm horrified.
I can't either.
I can't. That scene.
Ooh. Yeah, that scene.
I don't even have a vagina, and that scene makes me
cringe.
That
scene's rough, yeah.
Yeah,
rough.
A little bit.
But well, like
its bark was worse than its bite.
Oh! Yeah,
I threw that one in for a certain Evil Dead-obsessed friend of mine.
If you've never seen Evil Dead, we're not going to explain it. Just watch, no. Just watch the movie and cringe with us, because why should we suffer alone?
Exactly.
But,
obviously, he meant she is currently pregnant, and she tripped and fell on this path, and that could...
damage the infant,
right.
Yes.
But the way he worded it made it sound like...
Well, she tripped and fell, and now she's pregnant!
Yeah.
Sorry, having
like,
sex and getting
tripped,
pregnant.
Fell down, suddenly there was a star in the east, and poof, you know.
Poof, yeah. Getting pregnant is not, like, an accident. That's a plan.
Well, no. You can get pregnant by accident.
No, but I'm saying, like, the means by which it happens, like, no one has sex by accident.
Yeah, you don't trip and fall into a vagina.
You don't
trip and fall onto a penis.
Exactly.
You know.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, no. But and you don't trip on a stone and have a baby.
Yeah, well, no.
No. Not that I know of.
No. Was they say people in cars cause accidents and accidents in cars cause people?
Correct. The final tenant complaint, however, not the final part of this bit, is this. I request your permission to remove my drawers in the kitchen.
Say it again.
I request your permission to remove my drawers in the kitchen.
Remove your drawers anywhere you want. It's your fucking place.
He means drawers.
I gotcha.
But if you want to just drop trowel in the kitchen.
No one's going to stop you. This is America.
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 Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
It's like, well, I don't know. Are you hot?
You can, but slowly. Yeah, that just happened.
Oh God.
Oh,
I geez. Promise things won't get weird, Mama.
They got weird, didn't it? Yeah. Just like this segment.
It really did just get fucking weird.
It got so fucking weird. What the hell just happened?
Us.
Oh yeah, we happened. That would have been a great alternate title.
What just happened? Us.
We happened. Just call the show We Happened. Yeah. Or That Just Happened.
Yeah.
Actually, I think I was kicking around that title.
That Just Happened.
That Just Happened.
Yeah.
And then somebody, who I'd rather not remember, was telling me some story about somebody doing something stupid. And I went, you know, this is why the aliens don't come. And I went, ding.
Ah.
Yeah. There it is. I was trying for a month to come up with a title for this show. And yeah. And then the whole theme fell into place after that. Because originally we were just going to do like a geek podcast, but there's a fucking million of them.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's way too many of them.
Yeah, yeah.
And so, yeah, I wanted to do something a tad different than that. But, you know, I didn't want to just do a clone of the Nerdist or anything, you know.
Right, right.
But anyway, we digress, like we do. That would have been a good title as well. Like we digress.
Or like you do.
Like you do. Finally this week, you're going to love this.
Okay.
A preacher was completing a temperance sermon. With great expression, he said, "If I had all the beer in the world, I'd take it and throw it into the river." With even greater emphasis, he said, "If I had all the wine in the world, I'd take it and throw it into the river." And then finally he said, "And if I had all the whiskey in the world, I'd take it and throw it into the river." He sat down. The song leader then stood very cautiously and announced with a pleasant smile, "For our closing song, let us sing hymn number 365, Shall We Gather at the River?"
I was sure it was going to be Wade in the Water.
That's one river I want to go in. You talk about getting baptized. I feel the Holy Spirit.
That spirit, all right?
Yeah, several spirits. Yeah, I think maybe the preacher should have read ahead before. Yeah, he was talking about dumping all the booze into the river.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was going to get a bigger laugh out of you. Damn it.
No, I liked it. It was cute.
You're a rough audience last couple weeks. Especially this week.
Jesus. Oh, get over it.
No. I won't do the poop anymore. I will miss the poop. But we're officially going to retire the poop.
Thank you.
At least for now. Maybe someday the poop will return.
Okay.
But yeah, hey, if we get hate comments on Twitter and in the Facebook group, which by the way, if you haven't, you should join both of those.
Yeah, join. Don't post hate comments.
Don't post hate comments about losing the poop segment. And if you do, please Michelle, direct them at
Michelle
her.
Being all down in the mouth and no fun pointers.
Hashtag poop hater.
Poop hater. Yes. Proudly.
No poop shaming.
I won't even deal with poop at work.
You're a medical assistant. How do you avoid it?
I draw the line at poop. I'll draw blood. I'll dip urine. I've even cleaned up puke. I do not do stool samples.
Really? Yep. How do you avoid it, though?
Send them to the lab.
Really?
Yeah.
No kidding.
Yeah.
I don't poop.
I don't do poop.
Mm-hmm. Well, see, that's the thing. I say things like, I don't math or I don't adult, but I can't say I don't poop.
You can't say that, no.
No, because that doesn't work, because that implies I don't poop.
That you just hold it all in.
That I just get larger, you know.
And eventually die of septicemia.
Yes, there is that. Say no to septicemia.
Yeah.
Yeah. So in that case, poop is good.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a necessary function of life.
You just don't want to talk about
it. I don't want to talk about it.
All right, fine. This will be a poop-free show from here on out.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us this week. If you're new, welcome. Follow us on Twitter at
TIWTADC.
Join us on Facebook. Find us on SoundCloud and YouTube. This is truly why the aliens don't come.
This podcast is the property of Brendan Millett, all rights reserved. All music and audio clips used in this podcast are the property of their respective copyright owners. This podcast was hosted by Brendan Millett and Michelle Poitras. Opening theme composed and performed by Chris Lott. Official logo by Michael Magario at Pixel Pusher Studio. If you've enjoyed this podcast, join our Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/thisiswhythealiensdon'tcome, all one word.